Good morning, Knights, and welcome to the Westmount Highlights. It's the week of May 18th, 2020. Before we get started, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel if you would like to get updates every time a new episode drops. Also, feel free to leave a comment for our hardworking TWH crew members in the comments section below. On this week's show, we take a look at the new distance education schedule that's starting this week. Hannah confronts the evil empire on This Week in History. Brandon gets topical in our Riddle of the Week. Malachi listens to his inner Tom Petty on this week's book review. And as usual, we have new installments of the Mindful Minute, the library newsletter, and we'll take a look at some of the work you all have been submitting from home. But first, this past weekend, the phys ed department, led by the unofficial Toastmaster General himself, Mr. Casso, hosted the Westmount High School Sally Squats Challenge. We had a massive turnout and fun was had by all. Take a look for yourself.
I see, Hold on a second. I see you're trying to do something. All right, so I think we're going to start. Mr. Shapiro, we're good?
Bring Sally up.
Bring Sally down. Everybody hold the squat. That's right. Ready to go up? Bring Sally up.
Bring Sally down.
Bring Sally down. You're looking good. Hold the squat. Bring Sally up.
All of us at Westmount High, it's a gift of health. Remember that.
Thanks again to Mr. Casso and to the over 150 people that were able to join us. We'll be looking to break this record in June, so stay tuned for more information in the next few episodes. Last week, you should have received an email from the school regarding retrieval of locker items, laptop loans, report cards, and the brand new distance education schedule. This schedule has been designed to offer a bit more structure to your studies at home without giving you more stress. You'll have the chance to focus on at least one subject per day, as well as receiving direct conferencing and tutorials from your teachers. Please read through your schedule carefully, and as usual, make sure you're logging into your EMSB school email account at emsb.qc.ca. In this week's library newsletter, Miss Rebecca reviews Maybe He Just Likes You by Barbara D, plus provides updates on Google training, podcasts for teens, the EMSB virtual library, and more. A link to the document has been posted in the description. And speaking of book reviews, let's check in with Malachi to see what he's been reading on this week's 10-second-ish book review.
Today, Alan Gratz's Refugee. This is a good and interesting read. It has three main characters: Joseph, a Jewish boy, living in 1930s Nazi Germany, Isabel, a Cuban girl, living in 1994, and Mahmoud, a Syrian boy, in 2015. I had a lot of fun reading this. I hope you will.
Thank you, Malachi. Please make sure to check out Refugee by Alan Gratz on the EMSB Virtual Library. Also, let us know what books you've been diving into lately by posting in the comments section, or send me a video clip of your short 30-second book review to this email address, and you'll be featured on next week's episode.
On May 25th, 1977, the first of George Lucas's blockbuster Star Wars movies hit American theaters, and it was incredibly successful. It received 7 Oscars and earned $460 million in US ticket sales and $800 worldwide. It was like a revolution of movie watching. People stood in long lines in front of movie theaters across the country and around the world just to watch this movie. It was a mega hit.
First of all, I would like to congratulate Jana Lawler for guessing last week's riddle. Before COVID-19, John was going to a party, and as he approached, he could see in the windows that it was completely packed with people. He went inside only to discover that there wasn't a single person in there. How could this be? Post your answers in the comment section for a chance at a shout out in our next episode.
Now let's take a look at some of the incredible things you guys have been working on from home.
What are you putting now?
Vanilla. Artificial vanilla.
Longer. Longer.
Yeah, you
okay, put
off.
It into the cup. It's good.
Okay. Nice.
Kind of
taste it.
Okay. Look at that. The banana, the Nutella.
Yeah, slowly ice cream. That's good.
Huh?
That's good.
Yeah?
Thank you to everyone who submitted work this week. Please remember to check your school email regularly. If you're having any issues logging on, feel free to send me an email and we'll get you squared away in no time. From everyone at Westmount High School, we're wishing you all good health, and courtesy of our spiritual animator, Jag, here is this week's Mindful Minute. Be well.
Good morning, Westmount High, and welcome to this week's Mindful Minute. Our theme for this week is mindful in nature. The sky is the limit. Despite the recent cold temperatures, indeed, we are in spring. In fact, the beginning of this week marks the 60th day of spring. We know that nature helps ground us, makes us feel happy and connected to the world around us. At times, it can also amaze us if we just take a moment to be still in it. This week, let us take the time to be mindful of nature. Take a moment to enjoy its beauty and reach for the sky. If you can, find a spot outside, for example, on your balcony, in your yard, or on the front steps. Or, if you prefer, find a cozy spot inside near a window. And let's get started. Take a minute to focus on your breath. Take three long, deep, nourishing breaths. Breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth. Repeat this a few more times, breathing in through your nose and out through your mouth. Feel the breaths as they enter and fill your body. Repeat this one more time. Take a moment to clear your mind. Next, think about the following. Imagine the sky is the limit and reach for it today. Taking a deep breath, reach your arms up above your body and reach for the sky. Stretch your arms out and make your body as tall and expansive as possible. As you exhale, gently float the arms down and feel how the breath helps bring a feeling of calm and relaxation. Now, close your eyes and imagine that your awareness is as big as the sky above you. For example, imagine you are floating through the sky like a bird or a butterfly or even a cloud. You are free of worry and stress. Feel the wind and sun on your body. Open your eyes and feel calm and refreshed. Repeat the following words to yourself today. Breathing in, I calm my body. Breathing out, I smile. I am happy, healthy, safe, and loved. Enjoy being outdoors safely for a little longer this week. Stay calm and connected to nature. Have a great week, everyone.